and I'm all learning to. Sorry everyone, I didn't realize you were there. Oh, I think it's time for our week 7 assembly. So let's get ready for that. Today, boys and girls, we're going to be celebrating Book Week. So that's what we've been doing this week, Book Week. So I hope you've enjoyed it, and I hope you had a fantastic Book Week parade with your grade. So we'll be seeing some of those images of you in your costumes this week. So that'll be exciting. And we've got some great news about Fridays for the next 3 weeks of the term, and of course our awards. So sit back, relax, and enjoy.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Lord, bless this day for me and all of us. Make it a day in which we grow a little more like your Son, and gentle as Mary, his mother. Saint Joseph, pray for us. Saint Mary of the Cross Immaculate, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Hi everyone. I'm just here at our friendship bench now because a very important person in our school who's a really good friend to us is celebrating something really, really special this week. And you also notice I'm outside the church. So we can see the back of our beautiful church here. And that special person who's a great friend to us is Father Patrick. Now, Father Patrick this week celebrated 30 years as a priest. So isn't that amazing? 30 years doing the incredible work that he does every day. Every day he helps us to learn that more about God and to celebrate our Catholic faith. So we congratulate Father Patrick on 30 years as a priest. And I know at the moment, I spoke to him this week, and he's finding it really hard too, because he can't be out and about either. And he's at home as well. He can't even celebrate Mass on a Sunday. So Father Patrick, we're wishing you all the best. Congratulations, Father Patrick. We love having you as part of our school. Thanks, Father Patrick.
Congratulations, Father Patrick, on the 30th anniversary of your ordination, a wonderful achievement. From everyone at the St. Joseph's School community, we say a very big thank you for your service and congratulations.
Congratulations, Father Patrick. On behalf of our school community, our teachers, students and their families, we thank you for supporting us and guiding us through our faith journey. We miss you and pray that we can celebrate with you your 30 years as a priest next term. See you soon, Father Patrick.
Thank you. So this is a story called There's No Such Thing. And this is written by Heidi McKinnon. Okay. And this was a book that is shortlisted. Yeah, right. And on the back is our blurb. And we know that our blurb gives us a little bit of information. Bear can't sleep. What was that? Was it a hungry giant? A blood-sucking spider? A fire-breathing dragon? There's no such thing. Or so first we had the see or the hear. Now we've got did you feel it? They're going through the senses.
Do you think
looks like he's sleeping and it looks like he's dreaming of some nice happy things. You can see how happy they are all together. And that is our story called There's No Such Thing. That was a very funny book, I thought, and it was really.
It looks like she might be talking to a brand new baby brother or sister. You might make a connection to the story already. Maybe think, what's your favourite animal? Maybe Mother Nature didn't make a mistake with broccoli. Maybe it's your favourite. Do you ever make up your own songs or dance silly dances? Wow, look at the next day. Hope. Hope in the new day. Take a look at that. What will you, I wonder, add to this story? Look closely. And that's the end of the book. What a beautiful text.
Awesome. All right, so we're going to read this book. It's called Anemone Is Not the Enemy.
Anemone is not the enemy.
We'll notice that it is a book in the early childhood category. I still really enjoy this book because it has a really nice theme or a nice message that the author is trying to reach out to all of you. What kind of message it was trying to send to her audience as a reader?
That there are so many people in this world that want to be friends with you, just you need to find the right person.
Yes. Always try to understand others.
Sometimes you can't be rude to other people just because what they do.
Accept who you are and not want anything else.
Every dark cloud has a silver lining.
Happy Book Week, everyone!
Fisherman book. I'm Elvis.
I am Ed Brock, and I call myself Ed Brock.
But I didn't base mine on a book.
Who came the hat?
I'm Moana.
I am a skeleton.
I'm from Star Wars, of the Baby Yoda.
I am a knight from a fairy tale.
I'm Hermione from Harry Potter.
I'm a Roblox character from the Roblox book.
I'm Matilda.
And I straighten my hair.
I'm Dogman.
I am the Cheshire Cat from Alice in Wonderland.
I'm Billy B. Brown when she has a broken arm.
I think I'm Spider-Man from the book.
I'm Moana.
And I dressed up as the monster under the book.
I'm a ninja.
I'm Mr. Nobody.
I'm from a Wicked and the Wizard of Oz. Elphaba.
I'm Harry Potter.
I'm Sleeping Beauty.
I'm Rapunzel.
I want to be where the people are. I want to see them dancing and walking around on those. What's the word? Feet. Up where they walk, up where they run, up where they stay all day in the sun. I wonder if we wish I could be part of that world.
Dance.
In a show to love. You know the rules.
And everything is blue for him and himself and everybody around, 'cause he ain't got nobody to listen to.
So this is me. I better take off my glasses because she's only little and she doesn't wear glasses. And I am the little girl, from this book, and it's called No Never.
I'm on Riley. This is my new lyrical costume, so I decided to wear it because this one had all costumes in it too.
Ah!
Ollie Puppy.
No, very cute.
I'm supposed to be an elf from Rivendell, which is in Lord of the Rings.
I'm Legolas Greenleaf from the Lord of the Rings trilogy.
I am Tobias from The Girl, the Dog and the Writer.
I did Friday Barneys.
I'm Fanny Durack from the book Elsewhere Girls.
I was going to be the Cheshire Cat, but I kind of look like Harley Quinn.
So I'm the Gruffalo.
I'm Pippa Seagrave from the yearbook 2019.
I'm Jonah Moen from the 2019 yearbook.
I'm Jen Krogan from the 2019 yearbook.
I'm Carmen San Diego from the book Carmen San Diego.
I'm our mummy from the Hunt for the Sacred Papyrus.
I'm Tiggy from the Tiggy and the Magic Paintbrush.
So I'm Indiana Jones, and this is Shortstop.
You all look absolutely amazing. Happy Book Week, everybody.
From the Dog Diary series. There are 25 in our collection. This is my diary.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to 5M Book Week or 2021 COVID style remote learning book week. I'm starting off with Being the Very Hungry Caterpillar by Eric Carle. And I have got my juicy breakfast waiting for me when we finished our Zoom.
Hello, I am the odd ones out.
Hello, I'm Rapunzel. And I have the book.
Hi, I'm Queen of Hearts. I don't really have a book.
Thank you, little pigs.
I got my helmet, got my goggles, got my nose, and I got my jumper.
I'm a little kid and Santa is taking me somewhere.
Hello, I'm Mary Lennox from The Secret Garden.
I am the giraffe from The Giraffe and the Pelly and Me.
I'm Alex Jennings from Draycora, which is in the Mordorum Chronicles, and this is my book.
I'm just this random Harry Potter student.
I am someone from the book The Abominable Snowman.
I am a minion and I also have these glasses.
I'm Dharma Lama from this book. And I just printed out this mask and coloured that in.
I'm just a cowgirl. We did have a Jessie outfit, but I wore that in kindergarten.
I'm Luna Lovegood from Harry Potter. And I've made the glasses as well.
I am Mufasa from The Lion King.
So I'm wearing my devil stuff kit, as you can probably tell, when I've got my dance makeup on and my hair in a bun because... So the book is called Nice Girls Don't Play Footy.
I'm dressed as Sally Fitzgibbon from Live Like Sally.
I got the schoolmaster's daughter's book and I found a dress in my cupboard, so I just wore that.
I'm Dylan from the yearbook. So I asked my brother if I could borrow one of his Harry Potter robes. It's the Harry Potter book by J.K. Rowling.
Probably like a Bondi Rescue lifeguard.
I dressed up as a ranger from Ranger's Apprentice.
Yeah, I'm Arky from this Arky's Arcs or something.
I'm Stargirl from the book Stargirl.
house with a blue little window and a blue Corvette. And everything is blue for him and himself and everybody around, cause he ain't got nobody to listen to.
Okay, everyone, I hope you've been enjoying our assembly. Now, I just want to talk to you about something really, really important, really incredibly important, and that is about you and how you're going. Because we've been thinking a lot about you, and we've been thinking about how much time you have to spend on your screens, how much time you have to be sitting at a desk, how much time you have away from your friends, and how challenging that can be. So what we're going to do for the next three Fridays, so we've got week 8, week 9, and week 10 left, so that's three Fridays, we're going to have free choice Fridays. So what that means is it's going to be an opportunity for you and your family just to have a little bit of a break from your learning. And the idea of that is for you to be able to concentrate on how you're feeling, how you're going physically, are you moving enough, and how you're going socially. So are you doing enough activity with your family and having fun with your family, or maybe trying to contact your friends either over the phone or Zoom or something like that. So what the teachers have done is fantastic. They've put together this great sheet that's going to come out to you on Sunday with your weekly learning schedule, and that sheet is going to have a whole lot of free choice activities that you can do either on your own, or you might do it with some of your brothers and sisters or with your mum or dad. So you can choose those and it's your choice. Whatever you want to do, you can do. But if you want to do other things with your family, you don't have to do those activities at all. And you don't even have to upload them into Seesaw either. So it's going to be great. You're going to have a great day just to relax a little bit, because you know what? You've worked really, really hard and we think that you deserve to have Fridays off, but you can choose some of those activities if you want. So fantastic news, isn't it? Great job, everyone.
Congratulations to these KJ students for their fantastic work this week. To Una Lepinid for applying new sounds to words in writing. To Lily Nolan for her creative responses to stories read in class. To Zara Molinar for building fluency in reading. To Woodrow Crawford Clark for terrific sound talking and blending of words in stories. To Tommy Mitchell for a creative representation of his special place. And my PB Farrell Award winners this week go to Charlotte Radzminski and Portia Cole for being respectful, responsible and safe during remote learning. Thanks, KJ.
Hi KM, here are our awards for this week. Congratulations to Mahalia Stavro for using her letter sound knowledge to spell tricky words in her weekend recount writing. To Daisy Lanyon for striving for accuracy when sound talking new AI words. Well done. Violet Liplin for her detailed explanation of the 3D object, the cube. Well done. Caleb Longhurst, for always listening carefully and completing his work with pride. Well done, Caleb. For Lillian Lynch, for always communicating with enthusiasm in her Seesaw recordings. Well done, Lily. And our PB Farrell Award this week goes to Charlie McCann. Well done for being respectful, responsible and safe.
Good afternoon, everyone.
And happy Book Week. I would now like to present the Merit Awards for 1J. To Zali McKay, for always being a kind and considerate class member during our Zoom meetings. To Kata Lazuriagi, for striving for accuracy to read to punctuation with phrasing and fluency. To Noah Perkis, for always applying himself in all learning tasks on the learning plan. To Oshi Abling, for demonstrating great effort in your learning tasks. And to Rain Wright, for his fantastic letter writing. And our two PB Varel Awards this week go to Edison Barnes and Quade Sharman. Well done to all of our award winners.
Year One have had a fantastic week of learning and celebrating all things Book Week. So well done to everyone. Our awards for this week go to Jordan Graham for striving to use his letter sound knowledge to spell words accurately in his writing. To Will Payne for developing his phrasing and fluency in his reading on Seesaw. To Mason Giraldi for improved letter formation and bookwork. For Zali Burrows for applying herself in all tasks on the learning plan. And to Georgia Pierce for persisting with her reading during home learning. And our PB Farrell Awards go to Xanthi Bartlett and Hamish Barlow. Well done to all our award recipients this week.
Congratulations to all of the 2J Merit Award winners this week. Firstly, I have Eli Rowlandson for positive contributions to Zoom discussions. Alana Quadros Harrison for trying her best in all remote learning tasks. To Liam Pinkerton for positive contributions to Zoom sessions. For Ruby Dixon, for taking on feedback to bump up her writing. To Lani Brooks, for taking on feedback to bump up her work. And finally, our two Positive Behaviour for Learning Awards. Our first one goes to Jude Roebuck, and our second one goes to Blake Bertovic. Well done, 2J. I am so proud of all of the hard work that you are all putting in. Congratulations.
Hi, everyone. Well done to all of 2M for all their hard work this week. The Week 7 awards go to Phoebe Rowney for a detailed retell of The Prodigal Son, to Lucas Weeding for communicating with clarity his understanding of force, Abigail Cooley for communicating with clarity her understanding of The Prodigal Son, to Thomas Sillins for striving for accuracy when looking at language features in informative writing, Max Morris for striving for accuracy with quarter to and quarter past the hour in time, and the PB Farrell Awards to Elle Attenborough and Adam Liplin.
Congratulations to the following students in 3J who are receiving merit awards this week. To Summer Havartan, for responsibly uploading work to Seesaw on time. To Carter O'Loughlin, for experimenting with similes and metaphors when writing. Congratulations to Sophie Pierce, for attending to punctuation to ensure that her reading is phrased and fluent. To Leo Batson, for using great expression and intonation when reading poetry. To Harry Sterling, for his wonderful effort comparing Australia and Antarctica in geography. To Aidan Sunny, for using teacher feedback to improve his work and for striving for accuracy in sentence punctuation. Congratulations to these two students who received PB Farrell Awards this week. To Chloe Cripps and Claudia Newidock, for being respectful, responsible, and safe. Well done.
Good afternoon, St. Joey's. I'm here to read out 3M's awards. So firstly, for striving for accuracy when writing her shape poetry, we have Emily Ayres. Next, for responding with wonderment and awe when writing her whale cinquain poem, we have Kira Tanos. Next, for thinking flexibly when completing fractions work, we have Caitlin Darkoff. Next, for reading with enthusiasm and attending to punctuation, we have Ned Seagrave. Finally, for reading fluently with an exciting expression, we have Emma Clunas. And then for our PB for L awards, for being respectful, responsible and safe, we have Chase Lazuriaga. And finally, Ella Robinson. From Marlo and I, congratulations to all the award recipients. Bye.
The award recipients in 4J for this week are Rachel Cooley, for reading timetables and interpreting and understanding the information. To Sebastian Flood, for his engaging and informative report on the Black Flying Fox. For Ethan Matthey, for his book recommendation and rating activity on the book 130 Story Treehouse. The next one is for Ethan Abella, for his book week costume as a pilot from his favourite book, Fly. The last one is for Hannah McMahon, for her engaging and informative report on the feather tail glider. The PB4L awards in 4J go to Hayes Groves and Kate Hinchcliffe. Well done, guys.
Hi, boys and girls. And here we are ready for our Friday awards. Our first award goes to Charlotte Liplin, for striving for accuracy with time to and past the hour. Well done. Jacob Graham, for a lovely reflection about his harmonious relationship with his grandparents. Great job. Eliza Sigharbi, for making a creative film trailer about her puppy. Well done. Daphne Wheaton, for using a clear voice when recording on Seesaw. Awesome. William Bartlett, for striving to read clearly and fluently. Great job. Kobe Carfield, for accurate work when reading time to and past the hour. Great job. And here are our two PB4L awards, Adele Sharman and Lachlan Gray. Congratulations, guys.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to our assembly. I'm going to be reading out 5J's awards for this week. And our first one goes to Miller Hare, for thinking and communicating while completing many of her Seesaw tasks. The next one goes to Grace Sliakman, for being open to continuous learning and striving to do her best. Alex Bennett, for striving for accuracy during visual arts activities. Elise Davis-Reyes, remaining open to continuous learning and always striving to complete her tasks. And Hewan Clunas, questioning and problem solving during geography tasks. Great work with those merit certificates. And now I've got our PB for real. And these students have been striving to do their best and follow their home learning expectations. Well done, Ethan Kulia Giorgio and Sophia Brooks. Congratulations, everybody, on your merit awards this week. And well done. Bye.
Hi everyone. Congratulations to this week's Merit Award winners for 5M. For Addison Ward, a focused approach to remote learning and striving for accuracy with all tasks. To Kim Somerville, for always listening to others and striving for accuracy in all tasks. To Ellie Heath, for listening to others during Zoom activities. To Isaac Dixon, for being punctual to Zoom, listening to others and always doing his best. And to Arky Aveling, for taking responsible risks and seeking feedback when working remotely. Well done to those people. And our PB4L certificates this week go to Jet Donovan and to Jed Thompson. Congratulations, everyone.
Awards for 6J this week go to Zane Ashcroft for asking inferential questions to gain a deeper meaning in the text. Evelyn Haynes for striving for accuracy in her maths lessons. Cale Gross, taking responsible risks in his learning. Lillian Rouse for using her creativity to extend on learning tasks. and Abigail Hall for constantly looking for ways to extend her work products. And our two PB4L certificates go to Ruben Dami and Riley Henderson. Well done, 6J.
Good morning. Here are 6M's awards for this week. The first one goes to Cassandra Jones for an increased effort in her home learning. Next one, James Kerr for always being an active participant during our Zoom sessions. Lincoln Loveday for putting excellent effort into his home learning. Lucy Ransley for showing great persistence and striving for accuracy during maths. Maddie Reckles for striving for accuracy during all home learning. This week's PB4L certificates, the first one goes to Kalani Surgina, and the next one is to Nathan Nawali. Well done, 6M. Bye.
Hi, everyone. I have some art awards to give out this week. And these are for students in kindergarten, year one, and year five. And once again, they are for students who have really tried hard to complete their online tasks and have done really well in their art activities. Albie Bennett in KJ, Isabella Bemi, KM, Zoe Christodoulou in 1J, Cristiano Helena in 1M, Ollie Patterson in 5J, and Arki Averling in 5M. Congratulations to all these students and to all students who have been completing their art activities online. I look forward to seeing them every week.
Okay, everyone, that's it for our week 7 assembly. We hope that you really, really enjoyed Book Week, and I know your teachers loved having Book Week with you and dressing up in your costumes and all. But the important thing about Book Week is that it really focuses us on reading and how important reading is. So we hope that you enjoyed that. Boys and girls, we hope you have a great week of learning next week. Have a wonderful weekend and make sure to take care of your family this weekend. Thanks, everyone. Bye.